Three friends from Copenhagen work on the game Gooball and create game development tools to simplify their development process. Following the financial failure of Gooball, the developers decide to create a game engine with the goal of democratizing game development, making it more accessible to a wider audience. It will be called Unity. Unity becomes the most popular game engine for mobile platforms, with over 1.3 million developers using its tools. Software built with Unity runs on more than 1.5 billion devices. Apps made with their game engine are downloaded more than 3 billion times per month. Unity is behind the world's most lucrative mobile games, such as Pokémon Go and Activision's Call of Duty Mobile. Unity announces changes to its pricing model and states that they intend to charge developers based on game installs, even if the game is reinstalled or a pirate copy. Almost every developer is writing about how it could destroy their businesses and potentially disrupt the independent gaming market as we know it. Unity's offices across the United States are temporarily shut down due to target death threats. But why did it happen? Well, let's add some details. Unity Technologies is a growing business, and like any growing businesses, it spends more money than it makes. In 2019, Unity had a loss of $163 million, or the revenue of $540 million. In 2020, Unity Technologies had approximately $125 million in debt on its line of credit. So the company decided to hold an IPO to shore up cash as it worked on becoming a profitable business. After the IPO in 2020, Unity Technologies had raised more than $1.3 billion at a $30.6 billion valuation. To add context, Unity CEO John Riccitiello, who owns 3.5 million Unity shares, had a net worth of around $500 million at the time of the IPO, which tripled within a year during the year of 2021 bull run, thus giving the Unity boss a net worth of $1.4 billion. After the IPO, Unity Technologies began acquiring other companies in the VFX and game development industry. It's a logical move if your goal was to increase the value of their assets. However, the decision to purchase IronSource raised eyebrows. IronSource, a monetization company that had been abandoned by many in the industry and was struggling, was acquired by Unity for $4.4 billion. Notably, IronSource is known for creating the controversial Install Core installer, which is blocked by a Windows Defender. Following the merger, Tomer Bar-Zeev, the CEO of IronSource, became Unity's third president. Unity's decision to acquire IronSource led them to abandon a promising merger with AppLovin, which held the potential for increased profits.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
Unity announced changes to its pricing model. Their post hits record views and main reaction is shit. Charging 0.2 cents for any game install after surpassing a certain threshold essentially implies that user can reinstall games freely, potentially driving developers into bankruptcy. Not to talk about free-to-play games, which highly depend on downloads and had to test tons of prototypes before releasing their final game. A hasty and ill-conceived decision was presented without consulting anyone. Rumors suggest that the Unity development team had disputes with management, urging them not to implement the new rules, but their appeals fell on deaf ears. There are various ways to make a company profitable, and this decision appears to be one of the most idiotic of all. Personally, I first became acquainted with Unity in 2017, when I was creating a VR application for a university project. I found Unity to be an easy-to-learn and user-friendly platform with a great community, which raised my interest in game development. I have been working as a full-time 3D artist on the engine for 3 years and started planning my own projects. About half a year ago, I began working on my horror game project, and like many other indie developers, I was shocked by the news. I hope that Unity will come to its senses and reconsider its decision about the platform. 2 days after the announcement, Unity decided to clarify their new policy. It appeared they had realized that their actions had shattered the last shreds of trust among users and caused widespread panic. However, they were not in a rush to reverse the decision. They attempted to reassure the community by stating that more than 90% of customers will not be affected by this change. Now they claim that only the first installation would be counted, and for games from Xbox Pass, Microsoft would cover the installation costs. I can imagine the folks at Microsoft having a good laugh after. After all, if a small team of developers can get screwed up, it would be much more riskier for Unity to mess with a large multi-billion dollar company backed by a team of lawyers. Unity published their final post. It appeared that they were finally taking users' opinions seriously. The revised policy now seemed more democratic. The threshold cap was raised from 100k to 200. The installation fee now begins after reaching the threshold of $1 million within 12 months, and only for new versions of Unity. Additionally, users now have the option to remove Unity's splash screen. Collectively, users managed to convince Unity not to shoot themselves in the foot. However, a campaign to abandon Unity has begun. Unreal and Godot have already prepared to harvest new recruits. The wave of well-deserved criticism was primarily directed at the Unity CEO John Riccitiello, who had been leading Unity since 2014. Prior to his role at Unity, he served as the CEO of Electronic Arts, where he attempted to introduce paid gun magazines during intense gameplay in games like Battlefield. His statement at the time was, "When you are 6 hours into playing Battlefield and you run out of ammo in your magazine, and we ask you for a dollar to reload, you're really not that price sensitive at that point in time." In any case, the damage has already been done. The company's reputation has suffered more than ever. As an optimist, I believe that management and a board of directors will be able to learn from this, change the way they treat people to whom they owe their success, and make Unity great again.